Hello, good day. Welcome to Sports Update on the African Broadcasting Network. It's quite a start of a new week and great football actions across Europe, Africa, and Nigerians are still celebrating the victory over Zambia in the World Cup qualifiers. In tennis, yes, Andy Murray was in fine form at the finals of the China Open. I am Okyom Defekuji Obao. We'll begin news from the other side, coming from the results of the World Cup qualifiers from the African zone. On the continental game, it was a good one for Ghana earlier on, but the weekend was disappointment as they were held to a goalless draw by Uganda in Ghana. Gabon and Morocco played a 0-0 draw, and Congo DR whitewashed Libya 4-0. Cote d'Ivoire 3, Mali 1, Burkina Faso and South Africa also had a 1-0 draw. Senegal defeated Cape Verde Island 2-0. Zambia 1, Nigeria 2. Congo 1 and Egypt 2. Tunisia defeated Guinea 2-0. And Algeria were held at home by Cameroon 1-1 was the scoreline. Remember that also qualifiers to the 2018 World Cup continues across other continents, and in Europe, it was fine football at the weekend. We'll give you the result first before the fixtures will come on Tuesday. At the weekend, it was Wales who played a 1-1 with Georgia, Moldova 1 and Northern Ireland 3, Serbia 3, Austria also 2, Israel defeated Liechtenstein 2-1. Albania 0 and Spain 2, Macedonia 2, Italy 3, Finland 0, Croatia 1, Ukraine 3, Kosovo 0, Iceland 2, Turkey also 0. On Tuesday, we'll continue hostilities in Europe ahead of the World Cup, the qualifiers now for the European continent. Belarus will play Luxembourg, Netherlands will play France, Sweden will play Bulgaria, Andorra will play against Switzerland. Faroe Island will play Portugal. Latvia will play against Hungary. Bosnia-Herzegovina will play Cyprus. Estonia will also play Greece. And then Gibraltar will play against Belgium. We'll take you to other news now, coming in the world of sports. Of course, it was an interesting football game from the female perspective. If you remember, the FIFA Under-17 World Cup for the female in Jordan currently on. But then Africans saw two of their sides, Nigeria and Cameroon ladies, crouched out of the tournament. Ahead of the next game, now the fixtures for the quarterfinals will give you on the sports show. On October the 12th, in the quarterfinals, it will be for Mexico and Venezuela. Germany will play against Spain. October the 13th, also Korea DPR will play against Ghana. They'll begin for Japan and England. Meanwhile, Libya footballers have sacked their coach after the poor show of football in their 4-0 defeat to Congo DR in the World Cup qualifiers on the African zone. Coach Javier Clement have been sacked by the powerhouse of the Libya football. In a statement, the Libya football deserved better than the result, and also will look for a replacement in the shortest time before their next match on November the 7th in the World Cup qualifiers. So, tennis away from football, Andy Murray claims China Open, and that happens to be the fifth for him this year, and also for him the 40th trophy in his career. Andy Murray came over Grigor Dimitrov in a straight set, and of course 6-4, 7-6 was the scoreline. Andy Murray is on his way to become the world number one with the way he's going, and could be world number one before the end of the year and unseat Novak Djokovic with the fine form the British man have displayed so far in 2016. Remember, a sports update on African Broadcasting Network, and the program needs the best of your sponsorship. Our contacts on the screen, please fire us back and we'll get back to you as we'll look for the right sponsors on the sports show on the African Broadcasting Network. I will say thank you to Mr. Emmanuel and Mr. Uche. Of course, Anna, Mr. Tony, you've been fantastic and promise in your speech here on the sports program on the African Broadcasting Network. I am Okyom Tefekuji Obao. Keep watching ABN and stay tuned for more programs on the TV station. As for me, I don't work out. Bye for now.